You know how many practices I've done just to try to get Hall of Fame posterizer and relentless finisher. But that's not the only upside of this build. Defense is there. The athleticism of this build with the blocks. Almost getting 3 to 4 or 5 blocks a game. Walk on, it's easy. On the park, it's even better. Facing the rebounding post, go and get that out of here. You thought I was gonna jump? And rebounding doesn't matter as long as you have position. Then you also got an easy putback. Also getting the worst upgrades I want to becoming a 90 mid-range and post offense. That's what happens, man. 2K always does it. You can't choose your upgrades, but we finally made it to a 90 overall. 1 month later, looking back on this athletic finisher, we're going to be taking a look at these upgrades, man. So real quick, let's look at these upgrades again at 90 overall. Of course, you got 99 shot close, which means you can shoot at the close range and make a lot of those shots. 99 contact them, we already know that. Mid-range is what I got upgraded for getting the 90, and it's only still a 60. I haven't really taken a lot of mid-range, but the contested is a 70, of course. 3 points also a 58 open. Ball handling is near maxed out. Passing is almost maxed. Post offense, again, it's always maxed out, man. Like, I don't need this. Rebounding is a long way to go, man. I mean, our rebounding is only 72. Got to get it to 76 somehow. Don't know when that's going to happen. Steal is a 73. Don't care about that. The block, 73, but it works well. Vertical is maxed out, as you know. 75 helps on the rebounding and helps on the block. Lateral quickness is near max. Speed is maxed out at 70, so we need one more bar of that and acceleration. Probably we'll get that next. And then strength is only a 70, which is one of the main issues with this build. That's the only downside, is really the strength and stamina still 90. Now the badges, man, I just got Relentless Finisher Hall of Fame. Basically got Gold Putback King, which is maxed out at gold anyways. And then Posterizer is almost there. Just need about 40 more thousand, which is easy with the drill. I think offense on the top. So yeah, man. Been doing a lot of Relentless Finisher. It's easy to get this. It's easy to get Posterizer. And the other builds, like, mostly maxed out. Free throw ace. You're going to get to the line a lot with this build. But talking about this athletic finisher now, heading into some gameplay. After a month, and since I made this build, like, what? Maybe a month and a half ago. It's been a long time, man. Like, I've been using this build for a lot of games, man. Probably at least, honestly, when I was getting my Pro-Am qualifying games for the Combine, I was most likely using this build about 95% of the time, because I used this build on walk-on. In Team Arena Pro-Am, I was using this build because I'm one of the best big men on my team, and I haven't used my Lockdown Defender since maybe a month ago. Legit, I have not used my Lockdown Defender, haven't used my Slashing Shot Creator. You know, I've just been using my pure sharpshooter again. Haven't used my pure playmaker, so this is the only build I've been using for the past month. And I think I played a couple of games with my shot creating post score. That build is also good, but I think this build is a lot more dominant, man. And I'm gonna tell you why. This build is the most athletic big man, of course, obviously, because you're an athletic finisher. So you're already the most athletic big man. And when you talk about the big man, it's either two things big men can do, right? If you're facing a stretch 5 or a stretch 4, obviously they're shooting, but that's not a problem with the guard. Stretch 4s and stretch 5s are the easiest builds to guard because they're the slowest builds in the game. Not only that, think about it. The only way they can get open is by what? If they get open, which they can't really get open unless an off-ball screen set for them. And you know, no guard in this game, unless you're probably playing Team Pro-Am, is setting an off-ball screen for a big man who should be already setting the screen. So you already got that advantage right there if you're a pure athletic. Also the fact, 99 contact dunk, 99 standing dunk. That is huge, man. And think about all the builds in this game. I've rarely faced a pure rim protector, man. Like, I think I only faced, out of all the games I played at big man, I probably only faced 2 pure rim protectors. So there's not a lot of rim protectors in this game. So there's not a lot of people that can even guard this build. And then when you talk about big man, you talk about pick and roll and cutting to the basket. People, see, the thing about post scoring in this game, Nobody ever has enough time for post offense, man. Look, you can look at all the games. You can play team program. You can play walk-on program. People are running, first of all, in team program, people are running five out. No one has time to dump the ball into the paint and let someone just back down, especially since the easiest thing to defend against in 2K is post scoring, because you can just automatically bring a double team real quick and then go back to your man. So even that is not the greatest offense. So when you talk about a pure athletic finisher, you have a huge advantage all over the court, especially since you're faster than all the other big men. But your dunking ability is ridiculous, man. And like in 2K17, I said that the pure athletic, the athletic finisher is one of my favorite builds in that game, because also 2K17 was easy to shoot. So you can make a lot of threes, and this game is not that easy to shoot compared to 2K17. But this is definitely my top three favorite build in this game, man. I mean, it might even be second, man, because you know, I love my lockdown defender and I still like my playmaking shot creator. But this build, if you haven't used the pure athletic, this build is fun to use. And a lot of people have been making the rebounding athletics, which honestly, rebounding athletic finishers, when you look at it, that's also a fine build to make, because you still got the contact dunk, you still got the driving dunk at above a 90, standing layup might not be above a 90, but also you do get Hall of Fame badges with the rebounding athletic finisher. So I can see why people would make a rebounding athletic finisher. The only thing is that, you know, the rebounding is only slightly higher, but you know, like I said, rebounding, honestly, if the rebounding is not more, if it's not a huge gap in the attributes of rebounding between two positions, then it's like, as long as you have the position in the game and the box out, you gotta box out your man, you're probably gonna get a lot of rebounds, as you see me get the putback right there. But you're gonna get a lot of rebounds, man. You're gonna be pretty much fine getting rebounds in this game. So I don't got a problem getting rebounds. And like I said, the defense is amazing with this build, especially getting a whole ton of blocks. As long as you know how to play defense, you'll be fine with this build. And yeah, man, this build is excellent, man. I mean, I don't take a lot of mid-range shots, of course, but I like to stay in the paint, you know, get the putbacks. And think about it, I don't even have Hall of Fame posterizer yet. So just think about how good this build will be once I get a Hall of Fame posterizer, and I still haven't played a game with Hall of Fame Relentless Finisher. So this build, man, the sky's the limit, man. But anyways, let me know what you think in the comment section, man. Leave a like for more. This build is just definitely needs to be made by more people. A pure athletic finisher, man. I mean, make that 6'11 power forward. You know what's good, man. But anyways, I'm out for now. Peace.